Mervyn King trifft in dieser Runde der letzten 16 auf die Nummer 3 der Setzliste der International Darts Open 2017. Der Mann stand im WM-Finale 2010. Er hat die European Darts Championship 2012 gewinnen können. Aus Down Under, The Wizard, Simon Whitlock!
One more match in the afternoon session, one more place in the quarterfinals of the International Darts Open up for grabs. It will go to either the number three seed, Simon Whitlock, who came through at the expense of the original fellow Aussie World Cup teammate Kyle Anderson last night, or it will go to Mervyn King, a man who has made the final of a European Tour event this year, a man who, like Whitlock, has won on the European Tour in the past as well. Two players who know each other inside out, just looking at the head-to-head encounters of the past, and well, there are just too numerous to mention. The most recent encounter was earlier this year, for what it's worth. It was in the UK Open qualifiers, Whitlock winning 6-2. The last time they met on the European stage was in the Dutch Darts Masters in 2015, King winning that one 6-5. Very, very difficult to call this one, I have to say, Paul. Whitlock, you just feel now he's got that match with Anderson out of the way, he might well be a bit more focused and a bit more in tune with what's going on here.
Yeah, you may be right, Rob. I think last night there were hummings and awings of all sorts of things going on in the background. Simon to throw first. Game on. But as Paul Hincks gets us underway, Simon Whitlock will fancy a very good run because of the way he played last night. At points, he was just brilliant. But King, like you mentioned before, he's in a pretty good vein of form, and I've spent a lot of time with Mervyn this month, and he's so confident right now of what he's doing. He can't wait to get on the hockey. And in true Merv style, he was here with the cleaners this morning.
Well, King opened his campaign here with a win over John Michael 6-2 as Whitlock rattles in the first 180 of the match. That was his first win on the European Tour since that final, or since making the final in Leverkusen. He had a couple of blanks, did Mervyn King, in Maastricht and in Mannheim as well. Lost to Peter Wright in the final of the European Darts Open. So it's difficult to read too much into a 6-2 win over John Michael, the average 92. But on the evidence of what they've done so far this weekend, I think you have to fancy Simon Whitlock, because I think that was the toughest match that any of the seeds could have had, the way that Anderson's been playing of late.
Yeah, agreed. 145 for Wizard. 60 will leave tops. Now Mervyn will have a sneaky peek at 121. Would love a 60.
Treble 17, not to be. And so Whitlock will return as the favourite to take this leg now. Well, I say favourite. King's on 24. This has to go for Whitlock.
He was going for tops, tops. He's done it low. Now he has to hit tops.
16.
Ah. King comes back for double 12. Possibly a 13 dot leg. Doesn't matter if it's 14.
Or indeed. It could well be the break of throw, but it's not to be. And now Whitlock is surely the favourite for this one.
That was valuable as well. That was for a break of throw. And he's just telling himself off. And you can understand why, because now Whitlock has taken the leg. An opportunity has passed for Merv.
Yeah, and he wonder how many more he'll get like that, to be honest.
Yeah,
Whitlock is the sort of player who often just needs a couple of legs to settle himself down. He's got one on the board already. That was certainly the case last night against Kyle Anderson.
Yeah, Simon doesn't really dish out breaks of throw very often. He's not a guy walking around with a tree offering the most. Mervyn had the opportunity, unfortunately couldn't take it. And one of the reasons why he was in the commentary box for the last couple of European events is because he lost on the Saturday and was invited along 99. To join us on the Sunday. It was absolutely brilliant. But I, for one, am thrilled that he's not joining us today because he's playing on the top board. That's what he wants to do predominantly. 140.
Well, there was a key moment in that match last night between Anderson and Whitlock. It was four apiece, and Anderson had a dart at the bull for a 170 checkout, and it would have been the second 170 checkout of the day. But he hit the green stuff, and Whitlock was let back in.
And in the interview afterwards, Simon actually acknowledged that as well. He said if he'd have hit that, he probably wouldn't have won it.
And it really knocked the stuffing out of Anderson, because in the 10th leg, he hit one treble in his first 12 darts. And it was a treble one as well. And he never really recovered after that.
I don't think it's the last time we'll see Simon against Kyle in the match. Both guys highly regarded, highly ranked. Plenty more where that comes from. And double eight, double four for Merv. 70. And now Whitlock has an outside chance of nicking this leg and a break of his own. 419s and a bull, or 619s and a double six.
Not to be.
Well, there's the 26. 46. Mervyn can't afford to miss this time. That's it. And the last thing you want to do in games like this, start missing doubles and planting that seed of doubt. You can just see with that little shake of the head from the king that he's not particularly happy with what's going on right now. He's got to do a bit more what Simon's just done.
Second 180 of the match, both for the Wizard.
60.
It was a fabulous run to the final for Mervyn and Leverkusen.
It was. He was a qualifier as well. Yeah. So he did it the hard way.
Just ran out of steam in the final against Peter. And he took out Rob Cross that weekend after Rob Cross disposed of Michael van Gerwen. It was a great tournament and a great venue, which I'm very much looking forward to going back to in 2018. Leverkusen is a winner.
Yeah, it was one that I had to sit out, but if the PDC will have me back next year, it will be great to go along.
60.
Don't see why not, Rob. Especially with the wonderful sweater vest you're wearing this afternoon. You've got my vote.
Thank you, Paul.
78. Simon, you require one.
Well, a look of despair on the face of Mervyn King. Not sure what's going on yet, but if he hits this, he'll go for it. Loves a 170.
145.
Well, with King on 277, you can look at it at two ways. People will say, well, he didn't need to go for it, but when you've got that momentum, it's hard to 41. Resist the temptation.
That would have gone for it.
He's still got plenty in hand here anyway, so yeah, why not? Double eight then for a two on a lead to get his nose back in front. Double four.
17.
See, when you start missing like that, you start thinking to yourself, well, why didn't he leave tops of double 16? But that was in his shoes. I would have gone for the bull as well.
100. Simon, you require eight.
You'll want to ping it this time. Like I mentioned in the last leg with Mervyn, you don't want to start missing doubles and plant that seed of doubt. There it is. Very well done from Simon Whitlock. Used that marker perfectly. 2-1 to the Australian.
Winner of this to face Joe Cullen in the fourth quarter-final this evening. Quarters get underway at 7 o'clock. 83. Peter Wright, the number one seed against the Yella Klassen, the number eight seed. We have two qualifiers meeting up next. Dennis Nielsen of Sweden and Ron Mullenkamp of the Netherlands. Gerwin Price and Kim Huybrechts in the third quarter final. And then the winner of this to face Joe Cullen. It's all to come from 7 o'clock here from the Saxon 89. Arena on PDC TV HD.
Yeah, this session is definitely delivered, and the crowd have been treated to a wonderful session. I really want some more of that intensity tonight. Yeah. I'm not sure my vocal cords could take it, but I will go and shout it out until the cows come home.
And we will have a new name on the roll of honour here in Risa. No Michael Smith, 2015 champion, losing yesterday. Mensor, the defending champion, beaten earlier today by Gerwin Price.
Will it be a brand new European champion?
Well, there are still plenty of European Tour champions of the past in the field. Peter Wright is one of them. Kim Huybrechts is one. And one of these two as well.
59. I know how much Joe Cullen wants to win one of these. He will be looking at this game and wondering who he's going to play later. The more this game goes on, it's more like Whitlock right now, but Mervyn, what a way to get in the match. It would be with a bull. They're both had a go at it now and both missed the bullseye.
Yeah, we'll have three European Tour champions, whatever happens here, three European Tour champions in the quarterfinals, five potential first-time winners, and Simon Whitlock finds that all-important break. Very, very neat and tidy stuff, and Whitlock is going about his business very, very effectively indeed here.
A somewhat unconventional way of going for 68, but he's done that a lot lately. He seems to have a philosophy with 68 that if you have 14 tops, or treble 14, double 13, it works for him. And right there it works. So if it works, just keep doing it.
121.
What you don't want to do on 68 going that way is hit the treble 14 and split the 13s and you've got a dart in your hand you can't use. That's the danger. Mervyn's got his own way of going for certain things. We've talked at length about his love for treble 16 and his love for double 16. Sometimes when he's got 100, he'll hit a single 20 and go to treble 16 for double, and sometimes he leaves himself needing harder shots.
140.
Right now, his back is against the wall and he needs to come out swinging.
Yeah, King can sense the opportunity for a break here.
45.
Well, he should have been down to a finish first, but he's not. Whitlock 202 away, and not really able to make any significant inroads until that final treble goes in. 102 away now, so advantage Whitlock here, just about on his throw for a 4-1 lead, especially 40. If King fluffs his lines once again. And he's down to 155. Whitlock 102.
That leaves 42. 10. 10 indeed for double 16.
70. Mervyn Yukar 155.
He will be hoping he returns. He'll be perhaps half expecting to, and he will.
Well, it's frustration you can see on the face of Mervyn King. You can understand it. He had so many darts on the wires. Just like that. 32. Darts can be a very frustrating sport as a player. Just the mini step to the left, to the bottom, and he uses it very well.
Yeah, that was important for Whitlock. It was a good chance there for King to potentially break back. He was looking at Route 66 there to just claw his way back into this one, but Whitlock just doing enough here, isn't he? 89.8 the average, couple of 180s, 4 from 12 on his finishing. I mean, at times there have been really good patches, and there's another one.
What a picture-perfect 180 that was.
Almost equidistant spaces between the darts there.
Yeah, it's like you had a stencil for that one.
100.
Can he get another one? Has had a few 9-darters in his career. Well, you can see what he thought of that dart.
81.
No point talking about a 9-darter on the European Tour. It's never going to happen ever again. Joe Cullen got pretty close earlier.
84.
He got 6 perfect.
Yeah,
wasn't it?
Peter Wright went close as well. I think Wright had 7.
He had 7, yeah.
In the first match of the day. missing his lines or fluffing his lines on treble 19. Here we are again, though. Well, the nine darter might not be on, but he might be on for another emphatic leg hit.
140.
Good darts from Merv.
Simon, you require 60.
Pressure on the 60, but I know which shot I'd rather have, and that's the 60. Single for double.
Yeah, and it's on the king throw this as well, so he's got two bites at tops for a 5-1 lead. It's right Simon in the Whitlock. Top corner, a postage stamp from Simon Whitlock. Signed, sealed, delivered, maybe. He's one leg away from a place in the quarterfinals.
It's a good shot, that, wasn't it? It was like David Beckham curling one around the wall. Right in the corner.
Yeah, it was beautiful.
83.
I'm not sure how much of a fan of David Beckham Simon is. He's more a Aussie rules type of guy. Likes his cricket.
114.
He likes a lot of sports. He likes a bit of American football.
Well, he's Australian.
Likes to go golfing and hunt for snakes when his ball's in the bushes.
180.
Just beginning to turn it on now. He's got that cushion here to work with.
You ever seen Simon Whitlock hit a golf ball?
Can't say I have.
He hits it very hard. Hard as he's hitting this treble 20 right now.
Terrific grouping. We've talked about that time and time again as well. The grouping of Simon Whitlock, 58 points away. Another potential for an 11 dart leg hit. And Mervyn King is struggling for breath here to try and keep pace with Whitlock. He can't do too much here. Whitlock on 58. Two more goes at tops. And that is that for Mervyn King. It's the end of the road. And that is that for the afternoon session. Simon Whitlock brings to an end what has been another superb session of darts here at the International Darts Open. A 6-1 victory. An emphatic way to round off things here. Whitlock easing into the quarterfinals, where he will face Joe Cullen, and doing so with an average of 99.82. Not too bad on the finishing either as well, 6 from 14. He definitely steps it up in the closing stages of that one. He was just about doing enough early on, but he really began to turn the screw over the last two or three legs. Whitlock goes through. A quick reminder, the quarterfinals from 7 o'clock tonight. First up, we have Peter Wright against Jelle Klassen. Here is your latest winner. Join us again from 7.
Hit everything. I'm really happy.
Joe Cullen is the next one in the quarters tonight.
Yeah, Joe's playing really well, so, you know, I've got to pick my game up and play even better.
We're looking forward to that match. Thank you very much. Simon Whitlock freut sich auf die Partie mit Joe Cullen. Das wird das letzte Viertelfinale sein heute Abend in der entscheidenden Session. Das war sie, die Achtelfinalsession. Ihr macht euch netterweise schon mal auf den Weg. Das ist gut so. Ich will euch die Viertelfinals ganz kurz im Überblick noch mit auf den Weg geben. Es wird nachher losgehen ab 19 Uhr mit Peter Wright gegen Jelle Klassen, mit Dennis Nilsson, dem Schweden, gegen Ron Meulenkamp. Mit Gerwin Price gegen Kim Heibrechts. Das wird mit Sicherheit ein emotionales Match sein. Und abschließend dann Joe Cullen gegen den Wizard Simon Whitlock. Das war eine intensive Session. Das waren gute, gute Partien, die wir gesehen haben. Ich bin mir sicher, einige von euch sehen wir nachher, heute Abend noch wieder. Es gibt übrigens auch noch Tickets an der Abendkasse, wer sich die Entscheidung